I'm Dr. Ali Matu. New York City dodged a bullet, but the blizzard of 2015 rages on in New England. Let's break down the psychology of this storm on The Psych Show. It was supposed to be one of the biggest storms in New York City's history. In preparation, schools and businesses shut down, drivers were told to stay off the roads, and the city's massive subway system closed. Thankfully, it wasn't as bad as everyone predicted. The National Weather Service admitted that predicting how hard a storm's gonna hit is actually pretty difficult because atmospheric conditions can change pretty quickly. Most New Yorkers are gonna spend the day complaining about how Mayor de Blasio handled the situation, claim to be working from home when they're secretly binge-watching their favorite shows on Netflix and Instagramming the heck out of the storm. Here's the thing though, people are really bad at responding to these types of disasters, and public officials did exactly what they should have in this situation. Why? We're wired to respond to the stuff that's happening right now. Right in front of us. Not the stuff that could happen in the future, but the emotions of the present situation. If you see smoke, you're gonna run away from the fire. If you feel an earthquake, you're gonna duck and cover for safety. But blizzards happen gradually. There isn't any immediate sign of danger. Just like how you avoid writing a paper until the last minute or avoid filing your taxes until you're really stressed out about it, most New Yorkers didn't really care about the blizzard until everyone started to take it seriously. Hearing consistent messages from the government, from friends and coworkers is what will finally get people worried enough to act on the potential danger of a disaster. This is where social media really helps out. Seeing your friends' updates, tweets, and Instagrams is gonna carry a bit more weight than a message from a government bureaucrat. A lot of times politicians avoid issuing public alerts because they're afraid of wide-scale panic. But this almost never happens. In nearly all disasters, both natural and human-made, people are pretty well behaved. In fact, people actually become more helpful to one another. Throughout this blizzard, I've seen a lot of examples of people helping each other out, dig out their cars from the snow, and offering shelter in case someone loses electricity or, worse yet, the internet. Helping behavior, or altruism, always increases when we feel a greater sense of responsibility to someone and feel like there's something very clear that we can do. In a disaster, a sense of responsibility to one another skyrockets, and there's a lot of simple things we can do to help out each other. But there is one place where people do panic. The grocery store! Just check out all these images from Whole Foods in Union Square yesterday. It was madness. Long lines and dwindling supplies led to a widespread kale shortage in New York City. Seriously, this is a thing that actually happened. So if people usually don't panic in a disaster and are more helpful to one another, then why were people acting so weird and crazy at the grocery store? Same thing as I mentioned before, we respond to the emotions of now. On your way home from work, you might see a crowd gathering at the grocery store. Conformity kicks in and makes you think, hey, I should probably pick up a few things too. Once inside, you see supplies quickly fading and it creates a sort of Black Friday sense of competition. You might get worried that if I don't get this stuff now, I'll never be able to get it. Emotions of now more powerful than thoughts about what might happen later. That's why we heard stories about New Yorkers panicking about the dwindling supplies of kale. This is a theme that keeps coming up on The Psych Show. Our psychology is based on emotions, not logic. We're probably gonna see that play out over the next few days. Psychologists are finding that major blizzards like this are changing the way people see global warming. How could global warming be a thing if there's so much snow outside? Our thoughts about global warming are influenced by how warm the weather is. When it's warm outside, people tend to believe in it. And when it's cold and there's a blizzard, people begin to downplay global warming. Even though global warming is the force behind all the climate change that's created these superstorms. So what's the best way to help people prepare for natural disasters? Give clear and consistent messages that emotionally resonate with people. Then head to Whole Foods and let everyone know that there are plenty of other superfoods available if their precious kale should run out. How are you spending your snow day? Let me know in the comments below. Click on Snowy Midtown Manhattan to subscribe and get more psychology.